Okay guys, so I'm doing this video for the benefit of students so who are preparing seriously for the GATE exam. And so in this video, I will give the introduction so related to the subject, the foremost subject in electrical engineering, that is electrical circuits. So this is one of the important subjects in competitive exam point of view, not only for the GATE exam, any competitive exam related to electrical engineering. And this is the common subject for all the branches, not only for electrical engineering, not only for electronics engineering. So it is also a common subject for computer science and information technology students also. That means both circuit and non-circuit branches. So this is one of the important subject, and in this video just I will give the introduction related to this subject, electrical circuits, and you'll see the what are the topics covered under this subject. And when it comes to syllabus, I will follow the GATE syllabus. And in this electrical network, the first and foremost the topics are related to network elements. That means our discussion will be started with network elements, and the basic network elements are resistor and then inductor and capacitor. That means we will analyze or we will discuss about resistor, inductor, capacitor behavior and voltage current relationships for both for a resistor, inductor and capacitor. Similarly, we will see the definition or the statement for Ohm's law, and also we will see the definitions. So what are the definitions for KCL, that is Kirchhoff's current law, and Kirchhoff's voltage law also we will see. The next topic in this electrical circuits is network. Solution method. So in this we will see what are the different methods to solve a network. If there is a network, if you want to find out a voltage or a current, that means response, what are the different driving to solve a network. And again in this methods, the four most important methods are node and mesh analysis. So we will discuss about both node and mesh analysis, how to apply this node and mesh analysis to solve a network or a problem to find the response. The response may be a voltage or current. So right, so after that, the next topic in the electrical circuits is network theorems. So this is one of the important topic. So we'll see what are the different theorems in this electrical circuits and how to apply these network theorems to solve a network or to find the response, either voltage or current. So right, so again in this network theorems, we are having different theorems like superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem, so Norton's theorem, maximum power transfer theorem. These are some theorems we are having. We'll see so clearly. So after that, so the next topic in this electrical circuits is transient response. So this is one of the important topic in electrical circuits, transient response of DC and AC networks. We'll see the response, that is a transient response of both a DC network and AC network. And so one more topic also we will cover in this analysis, that is a steady state analysis also. Okay, now after transient analysis, the network goes into the steady state, right? So we'll see the steady state analysis also. Topic in this electrical circuits is resonance. So we'll see the concept of resonance. So right, what is the meaning of resonance and what is the condition to obtain the resonance in a network, and what is the condition for resonance in series network and a parallel network, we will see. After the resonance, the next topic in this electrical circuits is two-port networks. So this is also one of the important topic in competitive exam point of view. So in two-port networks, we will see the different parameters related to network. That means how to analyze a network by using these different parameters, we will see. And those parameters are like impedance parameter, admittance parameter, and ABCD parameters. Another name for the ABCD parameters. So transmission line parameters, and similarly H parameter, hybrid parameters, and we'll see the internal relations between parameter to parameter, how to express one parameter in terms of another parameter. That is also very, very important. After the next and last topic in this electrical circuits is three-phase circuits. So far, each of the topics we discussed are related to electrical circuits. We will consider only single phase AC circuits or AC supply, and for three phase we are having separate analysis, that is three phase circuits. And again, in the three phase circuits we will consider only balanced network or a circuit. We are not considering unbalanced circuits. So we'll analyze a three phase circuit with balanced condition. And again, in this three phase circuits you see both star and delta connection. So we'll see both star and delta connection. Is it okay for everyone? So this is the syllabus we are having for electrical circuits. So when it comes to gate, and keep in mind, so the gate syllabus, it's almost covers all the competitive exam syllabus. If you prepare all these topics, so with lot of confidence, you can write any competitive exam. And when it comes to electrical circuits, keep in mind, so we are having, so that means we are getting more number of questions from this electrical circuits when it comes to gate exam in every year. So from 10 to 15 marks we are expecting from this electrical circuits, right? So once again, so the topics in this electrical circuits are the network elements. We will analyze, we will discuss about resistor, inductor, capacitor, and the definitions of Ohm's law, KCL, KVL. After that, so network solving methods or solution methods like node and mesh analysis. After that, network theorems. What are the different theorems and how to apply these theorems to obtain the solutions. And then, so we'll see the transient response of both DC and AC networks. And then, so as usual, we will analyze status, so there is steady state analysis also. After that, resonance, what is the meaning of resonance? And condition for resonance for both series and parallel circuits. And then two-port networks, what are the parameters we are considering in case of two-port networks and their internal relations. After that, three-phase circuits. Okay, so, and in that three-phase circuits, we'll consider only a balanced connection. We'll see the relations for both star and delta connections. Is it right?